Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Oh, hey.
Hi.
Nice. Super exciting.
I'm going to get some music up.
Oh, wonderful. Oh, Reese, I'm still a little sore from that workout on Wednesday.
Yeah, it was all the backpack legs, huh?
Yeah, it's nice to have that feeling again. Even though I don't have a lot of equipment to work with. So shows just kind of like switching up either the reps or how quickly you're trying to do it can just change it, how your system's working and adapting in your body. So yeah, I'm sore.
All right. Very good. Well, I hope you're not too sore for this workout then.
Well, it's not going to be wonderful, but I'm going to be happy.
You'll be slightly feeling it, but
yeah. But there's not as much upper body, I don't think. Well, there's a little upper body today, but it's not as horrible. So maybe I'll be able to finish painting the ceiling. But yesterday, my arm was so tired
trying painting to paint. Painting the ceiling at your place?
Yeah, I mean, I have cans of paint in the garage and I don't have to go anywhere. So I might as well just bang that out now.
Yeah.
The good news is I found those masks that I bought like ages ago.
Okay.
Well, then I'll be able to go grocery shopping maybe a little later today. Facing the elements with my mask and gloves.
Facing the elements. I love that.
All right. We got one more minute, you guys. We have a couple of new workouts or new exercises, but we definitely still made this program that you could be doing everything really, really limited stuff. But again, I'm going to be starting with the bands because who didn't love how your booty felt after those band exercises? Yeah, horrible, right? But I'll have my weighted vest. I actually have a medicine ball and a kettlebell. Just be adding some more fun and more pain and then doing some of the workouts on my physio ball. But everything that Reese can give you can be a modifier for if you don't have anything or if you don't want to add that element of extra stability required. So just be patient. If you don't want to do that exercise, just keep listening because Reese can always give you a modifier. So it's 8 o'clock. So we're starting with the lateral band steps. Those really, really fun ones. Doing 15 to 20 each leg, and we'll be setting that with monster walks. So I'll show those right afterwards, but you guys can see me. Oh, there's the tunage. One side down. That wakes up the hiney. Oh my goodness.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us. We're warming up, so if you have bands, now is a good time to get them out. But like we said yesterday, you can do most of these without weights or bands and just focus on mind-muscle connection. So we're going to be warming up the legs right now. We're going to start with legs also. Good morning, everyone. Happy Friday the 3rd.
Okay, next one is monster walks. Be moving that band up above the knee. Just kind of doing the toddler diaper waddle, pushing your knees out, dropping your butt back, and doing little baby steps forward and back. 20 steps.
And this is another one where you can make this more difficult on yourself by moving the band lower on the legs if you need to.
Black band up high is working just fine. Thank you, Reese.
I like where it is.
Oh, yowzas. Hello, Heine. Oh. 30 seconds. We'll do that again. This is waking up everything with no heavy loads so we can get into our legs a little bit more aggressively over the next couple of sets. Whew. All right, let's start that again.
Right, and again, we're doing 2 to 3 sets, but if you are more advanced, you can always do upwards of 4 rounds.
Is there anything specific I should be doing with my body, not be doing with my body? Certain cues that I should listen to, Reese, if something doesn't feel right?
Well, I guess it just depends. This one you kind of just focus on. You'll probably actually feel the workout in both legs, your stationary leg and the leg moving, because you're holding your stationary leg in an isometric hold. So you'll feel it in that leg and glute. You're tucking, slightly hinging at the hips, slight bend in the knees. So this should be a pretty comfortable position for most people, but.
Comfortable besides the slight burn.
Yeah.
Oh. All right, it's getting serious. Layers are coming off. All right, monster walks. I'm keeping feet about shoulder width apart, but I'm trying to push my...
Right, exactly.
Keep it out further. And that's when it really...
Yeah, pushing against those bands. Waking those glutes up, getting
active. Are you guys feeling it? Let's see some hearts if you're feeling it in that tiny. We got about 30 seconds.
I need someone to top the using white claws as weights. So let's hear it. Let's hear what you got.
Oh. Only appropriate reasoning for bringing a white claw to a workout is using them as shoulder stability weights.
Yeah.
And then wear them afterwards, not during though. You need all your balance and coordination. All right, we're going to do one more round of that. Lateral, 15 to 20, loading up, balance, a little bit of bend in that knee. Turn up that music, Reese. I can barely hear it. Thank you.
All right, last one.
Woohoo! All right, monsters. Last of the band warm up. The warm up for. The pre-warm-up, the warm-up for the legs. Ah, I'm stripped. Okay. have a little rest after that.
Yeah, we'll just talk about our next set of exercises. We are going to be working again with two exercises back to back. We're going to go from the most taxing to the least taxing. So pretty much we'll be starting with legs and legs to upper body. Our first two exercises are going to be split squat jumps, but your modification will just be doing split squats with
a just holding in a pole.
Yes.
We'll see how many I can get done with this baby on. That'll be fun. When I say fun, I mean anything but.
I mean, not really going to enjoy it, but I'm going to do what I can. So yeah, if you have weights for this, dumbbells, or you can hold something or add some sort of weight to yourself, you can absolutely do that. If you're going to be doing jumping, you can just make it more of like a plyometric and do it body weight and do it for speed and explosiveness.
Yeah, if you don't have any weight, try to be getting as high as you can, the least amount of time on the ground, the quick turnover. Oh, brings back to the gym with Reese, doesn't it?
And then we'll be doing 5 to 10 on each leg, 5 to 10 repetitions. And our second exercise is going to be lateral lunges.
I'll shoot for 6 total with the weighted vest. I don't want to lose being explosive, and I don't want to be getting sloppy left and right. So I'll kind of see how that's going. So that'll be 3 each side, but this is definitely 45 pounds. I could really decline fast, so I'll see it, I'll feel it out. If by our third set I'm really losing a lot of everything, I might ditch the weight and just try to go for height and speed, because I've been building strength, and the last set's really good to unweight and try to go for as much speed as possible. Can everyone hear me okay? Because I'm way back there. Can
you hear me? Good.
Okay, let's get this over with.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining.
All right. Now we're going to go right into our lateral.
Yes. And then for the lateral lunges, 10 to 15 on each leg.
Start right here. You can see me.
Yeah. So lateral lunges are side lunges. When you're doing these, you just want to make sure that your knee is pointing in the same direction as your toe, not caving in or too far abducted outwards. Just in the direction of your toe, you're sinking your hips back when you're doing that, and that's going to also help you engage more glutes. The lower you get in this, the more glute engagement you'll get. Otherwise, you might feel it more in your quads or in your thighs.
I guess I'll try it this way.
Yeah, so she's hinging at the hips. The chest is coming slightly forward, but she's not rounding her back at all. It's going to maintain the neutral position. Pushing through your whole foot. The leg that's pushing away, that you're stepping out with, is the one that's doing all the work in this. So that's where you should be feeling it.
Wow. Good morning. Have a drink of water. Woo! You know, this is probably not going to be hard enough. I'm going to do this like 10 times. Just kidding. Got about 30 more seconds till we run through that again. Another reason why we kind of go supersets back to back helps keep the heart rate up a little bit. When you don't have access to cardio, you can superset things. Kind of keeps your heart rate going and builds into that aerobic capacity. Okay, let's do this. Split squats. Oh, okay.
Round two.
Oh, we always finish on the up. Now,
and the modification for that one, if you're not trying to do something so explosive, you want to just pulse up and down.
Yeah. Whew. Lunges.
Lat lunges.
Oh, other side. Change either just having that little light jumping squat back and forth with no weight or weight, or if you're doing that pulse because you're engaging all those muscles, you're just not getting explosive, but everything has to contract to protect your joints, so it's all working no matter which way or modification style you are using it. So don't give up. We have one more round of that. I promise you we're going to be getting into easier things as we go down the line. So stay with me. Let's do another round. Split squats.
Yeah. Finishing strong.
All right, lateral. Remember, when you're doing these side to sides, you can really start to feel the difference in your body. Notice if there's any imbalances. Notice if it's harder to go to one side. Then you're learning your body. You might have to make your own personal adjustments.
Right. So definitely make sure to always include something that's a single leg movement when you work out. So you can, one, identify the imbalances, and two, work on it. And you can just add a few more reps to that leg. Maybe you need to warm up that leg or that muscle group a little bit more than the other side, but it's very common too, so you just need to be aware.
Ooh. Oh yeah. I might do one more split squats unweighted just for fun and keep up the speed.
Yeah, you know, just for fun.
Just for fun. Just to make myself feel really fast because I don't have weight on right now.
Overachiever. Nice.
There you go. Oh, okay.
All right. So you should be utilizing your rest right now, getting some water. If you guys are doing this with us, we are about to move on to our next set of exercises, and we're going to continue on with two leg exercises. Woohoo! Are you going to be using your kettlebell for the deadlifts?
My weight vest is heavier, so I'll just pull that sideways.
Yeah.
I've got a little 5 extra pounds. My other kettlebell has not shown up yet. It's really cute. I'm really excited.
It's really cute. I
buy some gym stuff at home, so definitely splurged a little on Amazon for sure.
Yeah.
All right. Deadlifts.
Okay, yeah. So our next set of exercises are going to be deadlifts, and we're going to do 10 to 15 of those, and then we're going to do back extensions additionally. Just a 30-second hold.
So I'm going to be holding my weight vest. So I like to get more range, but slight bend in my knees, and then I'm sticking my butt back so everything is stacking up right over my heels.
So if you don't have a vest, if you have like a gallon water jug, or even if you have some heavy books that you can hold, that would be good. And you just want to there you go. Anything heavy you would want to hold, but if you don't have anything, I would recommend just doing a single leg modification of this, because it'll be a little bit more taxing when you do the single leg as opposed to the double leg. Yeah, so she's keeping a neutral spine. She's hinging at the hips backwards and allowing a slight bend in the knees. She's really flexible, so she can just about touch the ground. But if you feel the stretch in your hamstrings just after your knees, then that's perfectly fine for you. Come back up and squeeze the glutes at the top. Whew. And then we have back extensions.
I have a ball, so I'll be doing this on the ball, but I can on the ground first what we're trying to go for. And it's activating your glutes and your lower back. And if you're on the ground, maybe just hold it for 30 seconds. I'm going to be on the ball and doing reps.
You're going to do reps?
Or I can do a 30-second hold, whatever you want. I don't remember what I wrote.
You put 30-second hold, but let's just do that. So that way they can do it together with us, and then I'll time you.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Three, two, and one.
Oh, it's really hard on the ball. My hands is support, so I'm not rolling anywhere, but I'm still arching and engaging my glutes. Back.
Exactly. You're squeezing everything back there on the posterior side, your back, your glutes, your lower back, lifting the legs up off the ground. If you're on the floor, you can extend your arms out too.
I'm keeping my chin neutral, right?
Yes, exactly.
I don't want to be going like that.
Exactly. So you're not flexing the neck, flexing your extension.
I feel this in my hammies.
Oh. Three, two, and one.
Oh, yeah. That was different. Ooh, right here. Not so much here or here, but right here.
Good stuff. Okay. So right. We got a couple rounds of the exercises then.
About 30 seconds, and we'll start up at the top again with deadlifts.
Utilize your rest, get some water if you need to.
If you like the programs that we've been doing here, Fortis definitely offers more programs, especially all through the month of April. We'll be doing free classes online, strength classes, boot classes, whatever they're called, and yoga, all for free. Cerise is one of the trainers that cycles through that, but there's another handful of them. And they all put up really, really fun workouts and change up all the time.
Yeah, and there's classes every day, too, if you want to check Fortis's live story.
All right. Woohoo!
Round two. Squeezing the glutes at the top. This is a glute and hamstring movement, so that's where you're going to be feeling it. and you're getting 10 to 15 reps.
Not gonna lie, I don't remember counting. That's nothing new though. That's pretty par for the course for me. Whew. Back on the ball or back on the ground. We're almost done with our second time through this. Remember, I know you're getting tired, but these supersets will be getting easier and easier. So hang in there. We're almost done with legs.
All right.
On your count.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. And again, you guys can be doing this on the ground.
Especially after doing deadlifts, my hamstrings are already a little fatigued and I start feeling it there more. And I start feeling it there first.
Mm-hmm. 3, 2, 1.
Some hearts in there. How are you guys feeling? Are you guys feeling it in your legs? Woohoo! How do my workouts compare when I was at SMS? Well, SMS, you do a lot more stability, movement, control, and a lot of learning how to lift properly. So you're not using a lot of weights. Now that I've had that muscle patterning in my head for decades now, we'll skip that term, decades. How easier to be adding weight and knowing that I'm doing the movement properly and safely for my body. So if anything, it's just now more weight and trying to move it fast. But that was an awesome question. Thank you, SMS supporter. That was Stratton Mountain School. That's where I went to high school for all you guys that don't know what SMS is. But deadlifts.
Last round. Hello, everyone. We are doing our last round of this exercise if you're just joining us. We have deadlifts and back extensions.
And another thing to keep in mind when you're doing those, to not be letting your knees collapse in. That's another reason why we do those monster walks and all that band stuff, is to be engaging your glutes, but also keeping everything in line. And if you're lifting and collapsing, things aren't in line. So it's making sure everything is firing and working together. That's why it's so important to do your warm-ups.
Yes. And pushing the knees out also helps you engage your glutes more. What you want.
Last one.
What is she lifting? She has a 45-pound weighted vest that she was lifting. But if you have gallon jugs or anything like that, anything heavy would be ideal for that. All right, so we are back on with 30-second back extensions. 3, 2, 1.
I can hear the timer. Brings me back to minute math. Oh, God.
What are you guys lifting? Dogs? Books? Laundry detergents? 3, 2, 1.
Small children.
Small children.
Do you want a stability challenge? Stability challenge? Oh, Amazon delivery. Hold on. Hey, thank you.
You're welcome. All right. You are ready to rest before we move on to the next set of exercises.
All right. Bicep row. So I'm going to use a kettlebell that I have, but white claws are acceptable. Anything with a handle. If you are using something with a handle, just make sure it's the whatever's not slopping around and you're getting good consistency. So our first one will be a row. Our second one, if you have a handle like this, kind of hold it maybe like kettlebell style or cradle it. But I will have my kettlebell and I'll be doing a row bent over 10 to 15.
Right. And then I'll just give another modification. If you have one of these bands that we used at the beginning, you can use this to do a row as well. So if you, wow, you can't see my feet. So if you have one of these bands, you'll place it in the middle of your foot and you can row like this. So that's another option if you have one of these bands.
Oh, that is good. Thank you, Reese, for giving that option, because I know a lot of people have those bands. I know they're still available online. Those are great and have so many uses. It's not going to be something that's going to help you build crazy power, but it's going to be giving you muscle endurance and at least be maintaining strength and conditioning. So once those gyms do open up and you do get some weights, you'll be ready to hit them back hard. Okay. Doing shoulder press. I'm going to do my right leg bent, my other at a 90 degree. I've got a kettlebell. I'll be racking it like such. I can slide back so you can see it a little bit better. Right her. How many of these?
So for the shoulder presses, you're going to do 10 on each side. This kneeling stance helps engage the core, even if you're standing. And for any overhead movements, you want to make sure to keep that rib cage down, keep it from flaring and hyperextending your lower back, because most time we push up, our lower back wants to.
I'll go sideways.
Yeah. Our lower back wants to curve or compress the lumbar spine, so
keep that rib cage
down.
Doing this.
Yeah. Tuck the tailbone under, rib cage down. And then you'll press from there. And you're doing 10 on each side.
Oh, that side's harder for me. Boo. Oh. Okay, 30 seconds before we get back into rows. Remember the modifier that Reese just demonstrated with the band, or jugs, or kettlebells, or dumbbells, whatever you have. Let's just keep moving. So happy you guys are still with us and engaging. And giving us all the love, because we'll keep coming at you with more workouts if you keep liking, interacting. All right, back on top with rows.
Yeah, for these bent over rows, she's also maintaining that neutral spine with pretty much everything you do, hinging at the hips backwards and bringing the torso forwards. The row is a back movement, so you just want to think about squeezing as you bring your arm back.
And if you have super lightweight and want a different challenge, change it up. Make it a really slow pull, hold at the top, quick down, slow. You know, you can do some different variations to train your muscles differently, to challenge your nervous system, and then you can switch it up. So, back to shoulder presses. I'll go sideways again. Is that the better viewing? I'll go this way. Have the rack. So it's not slopping around. It's nice and cuddled against my wrist.
Yeah, kettlebell goes right behind the hand. And also she's doing opposite leg, opposite arm. So the opposite arm from the leg that is out in front of you.
Oh, painting the ceilings, I feel good after that. I'll tell you that much.
And then when you're doing these, you just want to make sure to bring your arm down till at least shoulder height. Or a little bit lower. If you come lower, you'll utilize your stretch reflex to get that weight back up. 10 to 15 on each side.
Whew. All right. have one more of those. Kind of wondering what showed up on Amazon. Maybe it's a band. Maybe I'll open it. Morning. Hello. There you go.
For the shoulder presses, yes, you can use the bands.
Look what band just showed up. Oh, yeah.
Nice. Ooh. If you have one of those big ones, you could do shoulder presses. Like, you could do a squat to press with that, how Lindsay was just holding in front of her. The suspense of what Amazon brought, yeah. If you have one of these, it's going to kind of be awkward, but you can try, like, holding one up and pressing up. But ideally, a bigger band would be better.
Okay, I'm back to the rows.
Yes.
Really making sure I'm pinching that rhomboid and shifting my scapula to really crush the white claw that's resting in my back for later.
If you only have a small band, you can place it in your arms like this and do an overhead press like so. And you're placing tension on the bands, and that'll give you the same effect of doing an overhead press. Thanks for asking, Patricia. I appreciate you. Someone commented, Lindsay, they said the suspense of what Amazon brought.
Oh, I'll show you. It's another workout item after this set. I will share, and I will share a fun thing you can do with it.
And then just make sure when you're pressing up overhead, Lindsay, that your wrist is above your shoulder. So your arm should be right. There you go.
This side has a hard time with mobility. So thank you for bringing that to my attention.
Yeah. So when you punch up overhead, for everybody else who's watching, your wrist should be directly below your shoulder. And if you have any like tightness of the traps or something, you might not be able to get your wrist that high.
So this is what just showed up on Amazon. It is a way bigger band.
Yeah, and mega bands. You can do a lot with those.
You can do a lot with this. And this one's really tight. I can do like a front squat with this, and I can have it right up against my chest and be dropping back. But this baby's going to have to break in some because, whoa, that's tight. A lot of upper body stuff. If you have any hooks up high, also it could be another good row. I could step on it like this and row up. So this is another fun thing. Definitely check out what kind of bands and fun things you can find online. Leave them on a pile in the middle of the living room so you see it, and encourage yourself to get doing something active a couple times a week.
Right.
That was our last set of our upper body. What are we going to next?
So this is our last set of exercises. We have Russian twists. We're Russian twists and an ab crunch with or without weight.
So an ab crunch like on a ball or on the ground. And I was going to add weight either holding the dumbbell probably the kettlebell is going to be the easiest. I'm going to do Russian twists right now. I'm going to do 30 each side, so I'll just count when I hit one side, so I'm not having count to 60.
Yeah, and for these, she's doing a more difficult version by having her legs up as well, because you have to add that extra stability and balance on your butt. But you can do this with your legs down too if you're not quite there yet. And then she's just feeling this really in your obliques when you go side to side. But yeah, if you do have a weight, you can definitely do this body weight. But if you do have weights at all, something that you can hold for this, then that would be good too.
Yeah, you can easily just be having your feet planted and with a little bit of weight back so you feel that engagement. You're right before your legs are about to be pulled up. That's when you go left to right. You'll have less stability to having to be dealing with, but you'll still be engaging. And I definitely even feel it without the weight because everything has to be moving and transferring to stabilize as you're going left to right. So no excuses if you don't have the weights or all the equipment. There's always a modifier. You can always be getting something from it. Next, I'll do,
Lindsay's gonna do this on the ball, but this is one that you can definitely just do on the floor. She's gonna be using a weight. But again, you do not need a weight to do these crunches. You can do them on the floor. It would be the same position, essentially. And she's going to be doing 30 of them.
Or 20, because that's all that's really going to happen. But when you're on the ball, you can do, instead of making sure you're just going from a flat position like you'd be on the ground, when you go down and extend, you can actually arch and give a little posterior arc. And then when you come up, anteriorly curve in. And you can get that kind of workout and feel without weight. Even if you have no weight and you're on the ball, you can definitely get that. And you'll feel it in your whole abdominal wall.
Yeah, when you do it on the ball, you get a little bit more range of motion. Than you would on the floor.
All right, 30 seconds, then back to Russian twist. You guys are almost done. I love that I keep seeing all the hearts coming in and you guys are still following along. We'll stay for a few more minutes. You can ask Reese maybe a couple more questions. She's very, very knowledgeable in this. So throw them her way. Russian twist.
Yeah, thanks for joining us, you guys. Yes, we will be doing some more workouts and we'll just, keep you updated on my personal or my fitness Instagram, which is Reese H Fit, Fortis's Instagram, and then Lindsay's Instagram. You'll be able to see when we're doing it next. So just stay tuned through either of those Instagrams.
Oh. Definitely give Fortis a call or Fortis a follow. And Reese to follow because they're doing workouts the whole month of April. Reese does a bunch of other classes throughout the day. I definitely want to be working out still Monday, Wednesday, Friday. That's normally when I'd be working out. So I just have to be modifying my life a little bit, but still working. I'm still getting a good workout and I'm very sore at the end of these. So something's working.
Yeah, and if you guys could get at least like 3 workouts in, 3 to 5 if you're more advanced, just to help you maintain your muscle mass and strength.
One more round of those. Oh my gosh.
One more round, people. We're almost done.
You're going to be so energized the rest of the day, be able to change out filters or clean or do other tasks or emails because you have all these endorphins surging through your body because you worked out. And then it becomes an addictive pattern and you want to keep doing it. A few more seconds. We'll start at the top. We're almost done. Stay with me. Russian twist. Here we go.
Hello, everyone.
Okay. Good Lord.
So many hearts.
Oh.
Whoa.
Not skip your core because it's another stabilizer for all your back muscles. If your back is getting sore a lot, sometimes it could be meaning that your core is not engaging. Might be strong, but it might be missing the cues to fire and protect everything. So don't skip core when you're watching Tiger King or splurging on your next thing. Get on the ground and start doing some crunches. Oh my gosh. Woohoo! Oh my gosh. You guys, great job. So happy that you guys hung around.
Lower this a little bit.
I hope you enjoyed that workout. That was definitely challenging for me, and I definitely feel it. So hopefully over the next few days, you'll be feeling a little sore, so try to be kind to yourself and stretch and do some movement prep and maybe some yoga to recover, but know that you're building your muscles, you're building strength in all your stabilizers, and it's really, really exciting. Do you guys have any questions for Reese? Well, we have a book of knowledge right above me. Who's got any questions?
Also, if you guys do want to do yoga or anything like that, Fortis offers yoga just about every single day, so definitely check that out. Sometimes they offer, like, a deep stretch class. I did that the other day. It was actually really nice.
But all free classes for the whole month of April.
Yeah.
That's not an April Fool's Day joke. That is actual truth.
Yeah.
So, free classes for Fortis. Reese is one of the trainers, so you can log on any time in the day, see what they're doing live. They post their schedules. You can see what you can get into. But we'll definitely be doing more workouts together. I definitely have a lot of fun working out and challenging myself with Reese. So she usually finds some creative way to punish me. So even with our limited torture tools. So I hope you guys had a great time. You can definitely, you know, comment on Reese or any of my pictures to ask questions. If you missed it during here, we'll have this going live. But definitely keep going, keep strong with your workouts, and thank you guys so much for joining. Thank you so much, Reese.
Thank you. And yeah, direct message us, let us know if you like these workouts, if you have any comments or suggestions, or if there's just like any exercises that you want to go over, let us know.
Awesome. All right. Bye guys, thank you so much. Bye.